Greetings fellow Earthlings, welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with the scenario independent quick missions. The next mission at hand is mission DAPS. I don't know why they call it that, and even though I've completed playing this mission, I still don't know why they call this mission DAPS. But yeah, it takes place in Central Asia, 0925 hours in the morning, and the skies are clear as ever. Now, this mission was by far the most difficult mission in the entire campaign, the quick missions, and in fact it was the most difficult mission in the entire game, to be honest, because I played missions that were easier in the main campaigns, both the campaigns combined, I mean, so yeah, that's saying something. So rebel forces have recently seized control of government supply depot. Retake the depot and destroy the enemy center that is coordinating the recent offensive moves. So yeah, let's just take a look at the briefing and you guys will realize what I'm talking about.
Rebel forces have seized control of a government supply depot. Their movements are being coordinated from a communications outpost northeast of the depot. We need to cut off their communications and retake the depot. Bravo will insert east of the comm center and eliminate all hostile forces. Alpha and Charlie teams will surround the depot and wait for Bravo. Once the comm center is knocked out, all three teams will converge on the base and eliminate all hostile forces. The enemy is known to operate attack helicopters in the region. You may have to deal with an airborne threat.
Yeah, she says you may have to deal with an airborne threat, and the wording is sort of the key there, because it's half a lie and half a truth. You may have to deal with an airborne threat, that is the half which is true. Whether or not you have to deal with an airborne threat sort of depends on your actions leading up to a certain point. So we've got two objectives here. This is objective day and this is objective night. And what we need to do is this red building right here, that's a bunker in objective day. So what we need to do is eliminate everybody inside the bunker and make sure that nobody else can get inside the bunker and touch any of the communications equipment and call, well, the airborne threat for help. Once that is done, then we are free to essentially take out any and all enemies down here. That being said, the second part of the sentence, an airborne threat, that's a lie. Because let me show you guys something. Yeah, there are four airborne threats in this level. These two are light attack helicopters, and these two are heavy attack helicopters, which actually carry more troops. And not only that, there's actually a Hercules dropship that drops like 6 or 7 paratroopers down along this ridge line right here to reinforce the already reinforced troops should anybody ever make it to the bunker and alert these guys to come for their aid. So yeah, this mission, the first half of this mission requires stealth, and if you somehow trigger the alarm, well, it's game over for you, unless you're like super skilled and can play Delta Force the same way you play Call of Duty. So yeah, and to just add to all of that trouble, all the people inside this base, they are very quick. They have got lightning fast reflexes and they're very accurate. They're quick draw champions essentially. Anyhow, you'll get to see what I'm talking about when we actually get to playing the game. So for this mission, I basically took a M4 carbine with a grenade launcher to clear out the rooms, a SOCOM 45 suppressed, which I would be using extensively during the first half of the mission. I took a law with me, and I took a ghillie suit with me so that I could blend in with the environment better, mask my signature easier, because this is a mission which requires stealth for a portion of the first, until you acquire a portion of the first objective. And let's just say that this game isn't exactly optimized for stealth. So that's essentially where we went sideways with this mission, I would say. Anyhow, That's essentially what makes this mission difficult. If you go in guns blazing, you have just that many more threats to deal with. And yeah, that's essentially what makes this mission difficult. Anyhow, I've been prattling on for long enough. Let the post gameplay commentary me take over from here. Yeah.
Bravo, King 6. Do not alert the enemy to your presence until you have disabled the communications center. It is imperative that this base be cut off from reinforcements.
So this first part of the mission is extremely sensitive because you have to maintain stealth in a game that doesn't really let you maintain stealth as well. And to that effect, we literally have to just make it to that guy in front of us and shoot him with a pistol. Now, the trick to using this pistol is that you need to fire your shots in bunches. If you don't shoot in bunches, then you'll more or less just end up wasting your shots. And yeah, so we sneak up to him. This guy seems to be aware of us already, and we head up and shoot him a few times, twice in this case, to get rid of him. And there's another guy near the bottom of that base over there that we need to take out silently, of course. And a few shots for him as well, but he did make noise. Luckily though, nobody was alerted. Now the reason you need stealth in this section is that the bunker on the left, there's a guy over there as well, and I was just checking to make sure that nobody accidentally turned on the night vision there. I was just checking to make sure that nobody sort of accidentally got aware of us. Anyhow, the reason we need to make sure that we are stealthy is because we do not want any of the people inside that bunker who are standing in front of communications equipment to alert their aerial base. Because once they alert their aerial base, we will have four entire choppers headed our way, and it is not a pleasant experience at all. So we will get to this gate here, and from there on out, it will be a very quick lightning strike. So as soon as we get this guy, it's open season, essentially. And yeah, we'll start in time now. I'm just mustering the nerve to do it. I shoot him, and I take that guy out on the tower because he is a threat, despite the fact that I'm wearing a green suit. I take that guy out. Took way too many shots, way far more shots than I had counted on. And we take this guy out, missed again, and this guy. And that's the end of that. Now we just need to make sure that nobody enters this space. Now I'm just crawling back until I can see both ends, both entries into this compound. I can keep an observation. If you look at the minimap at the bottom right, you will see a guy heading towards us. He will not be able to enter from that side. He will have to come around from in front of us. And that is who we are waiting for right now. And he'll be there shortly. Oh boy. Now that this guy is dead, his buddy will be coming from over on that entrance, the one we just cleared out, and the one we just came in from. And when he comes, we will have to shoot him as well. So I'm just waiting for him. Sometimes he usually takes his time coming because he takes a more roundabout route. But effectively flanks us from behind. If we did not have the minimap, we probably would not have been able to see him. And there he is. You can see him on the minimap. And as soon as he enters the fray, we shoot him. Not ready for CSGO, pro CSGO pixel peeking yet. There are two people in there, and as soon as you kill them, you have got the clearance to go ahead and
good work, Bravo. Proceed with the assault on a lower base.
Attack the base on the lower side. Now, the reason that we need to do all of this is because otherwise, not only do the helicopters arrive, four attack helicopters arrive, there are so many more enemies all over the place. And every single enemy in this mission, in this particular mission, is highly trained. So at this point, I'm just trying to shoot out as many guys so as to protect Alpha and Charlie teams. That guy as well. I think that guy's dead. But yeah, I try my best to take out as many enemies.
Charlie 2 is hit!
As a result, I'm sort of rushing all over the place and missing my shots.
Charlie's down!
I'm trying to find a guy that's supposed to be sitting there. And yeah, Charlie team is down, Alpha team has successfully
reached the perimeter. This is Alpha 1, we breached the southern perimeter!
But even they die in their
Alpha 1 is down!
Unfortunately.
Bravo, King 6! Alpha team is down!
That is quite sad. Anyhow, I'm still basically trying to maintain a level of caution. I was prepared for this outcome. I just wish they did not have to die, but yeah, I was prepared for this outcome. And there's that guy that was looking for, but this metal crating protecting him from my shots. The only reason that I took an assault rifle for this mission instead of a sniper is the fact that we need the grenade launcher to clear rooms. There are lots of rooms to clear. Most of these houses have enemies in them. And I was just looking at the map because there are two enemies that keep running along the perimeters that have lightning quick reflexes, and they will not hesitate to gun you down. They've got accuracy. I just like blow the barrel up nonetheless. Yeah, they're really accurate and they've got like lightning quick reflexes. I will attempt to take this guy out here. We'll just take a few shots. But I will eventually get him. And get him I too. And while I'm still running, I'm gonna try to clear out any of these other buildings that might have the soldiers inside of them. The sentry box we have already taken out. At this point, I'm only worried about the person running on the southern, along the southern perimeter, and a couple of guys in front of this helipad right here. And we won't see the guys in front of the helipad just yet, but we will be. This guy running along the southern perimeter will stop to take a shot at us. Luckily for us, from this range, he will find it difficult to hit us. And yeah, this is one of those missions where caution is of utmost importance. Just because of how accurate and quick the enemy AI is. They forgot to tone it down, so yeah, it makes it a difficult mission. I do believe TAPS is essentially the most difficult mission in all of Delta Force 2. I mean, yesterday when I was playing it live, I had to play it like 25 times, and even then the video recording that came out was absolutely unusable, so I had to go ahead and replay this level this morning one last time, and yeah, I got it on the first try itself, so kudos. But then the audio recording sucked, so instead of playing it again, I decided to just do a post gameplay commentary, even though it's all the more work for me. But yeah, I will take that over replaying this mission, and the next one for that matter. I mean, this mission I could get it down because I sort of developed the memory for it, the memory for the lay of the land. But the next mission, we don't really get that. That's it's heavily based around RNG. So yeah, in this mission, this is the way you play it. You maintain stealth until you can storm the bunker, and you do need to absolutely storm the bunker, because if you do not storm the bunker, they will radio in for the helicopters, and the helicopters will ruin your day unless you can play this game like you're playing COD. Don't bother. Do not bother going in guns blazing. If they radio in for the helicopters, abandon all hope, just die and restart. But if you can play that well, or if you have the requisite skills for it, feel free to try. That is all I will say. Because, I mean, there are 4 helicopters, and the maximum amount of loss you can carry is 4. 2 of them, of course, don't really do much, they just hover around in place. I'll be showing all of that anyway, so I'll just shut up for now. Back to this recording here. So, that building has an enemy in there. There's no enemy inside of this building right in front of us. But we are still checking nonetheless. Now, that building on the left should have an enemy, but in this case, Alpha 2 took them out. We don't know that yet, of course. So, I didn't know that yet. So, I'm still headed down slowly, gently, trying to figure out where this guy is. And hopefully put a bullet in him. I'm still checking around for some enemies. Now, this third enemy there that Charlie typically manages to take out, but in this instance, they just sort of forgot to do that. They could not take him out. Not that they forgot, they just more or less died before they could ever take that poor soul out. Rest in peace, Charlie Fireteam. Fireteam Charlie, rather. And luckily, they don't kill me before I get to see them, and I do get to see them before the end of the level. So, that's good for me, I suppose. Anyhow, from this angle, you should be able to see the guy inside that building, and maybe just adjust your angle a little. Do not stand and walk. That might seem like an enemy, but those are essentially the legs of a table, not the legs of an enemy. No point in shooting them. There's no other enemy apart from the one that you can take out. Yeah, that's the other enemy right there. Yeah, so in this house, there's only one enemy that is near the gate right there, and there are no other enemies. You can just take him out from near the near objective day itself, or perhaps was it objective night? I forgot at this point. Anywho, yeah, at this point is when I hook a left and go behind these buildings, because staying in the center is essentially
Bravo, King 6, clear the buildings.
Putting myself in a kill box, which is not a favorable solution for anybody. So in this instance, I'm trying to get like a favorable opportunity to lob in a grenade, and instead I walk in too far and expose myself to the enemy. I get shot, but thankfully I don't die, and that was the only enemy in there. There are no other enemies, but I just still lobbed a grenade in nonetheless. And there's another enemy inside of this building here. We should probably move in cautiously and lob a grenade. And you could hear him die. And that's the enemy that we wanted to be aware of. This one has no enemies, but in case there is one in this run, I decided to just chuck in a grenade launcher nonetheless. And I go in. And yeah, I equip my law to take out this box. Hoping to take the guy out that you can see there behind it. Except that doesn't work out. So we're just sort of left with nothing to show for it. Now, I haven't noticed that other guy yet. I will once that guy shoots at me. So, yeah, right now. I smartly move into cover. I don't know where I find all these guns all of a sudden. And I use the barrels to take him out, because why not? Explosion's cool. I have male brain, simple. The first time that I was playing this mission and I got this far, I accidentally blew myself up using a grenade. And that was literally the last enemy, the one to our left that we are about to take out right now. He's hiding at the corner. And it will take us a few grenades. The next grenade will get him though. And yeah, that was the enemy that we were trying to take out.
Good work, Bravo. The area is secure. Stand by for extraction.
And that is essentially what drove me so mad back then, because I put so much effort into getting here, and in the end it didn't even matter, because that guy, well, he just shot me nonetheless. I even took out the helicopters in that run through. It's not a reliable strategy at all, but I did take out the helicopters in that run through. Anyhow, that's that for this mission. Well, actually, at this point, I do believe I begin showing you guys what will happen if I decide to, well, more or less just, how do I put this, play it in a non-sneaky fashion, just to show you guys.
Bravo, King 6, do not alert the enemy.
Yeah, right now I just want to go stealthy. Sorry, I wanna say fuck you to stealth, and just show you guys what's gonna happen, what is bound to happen in case you decide to essentially, you know. Just launch an all-out offensive.
Bravo, the base is ready out for help. You're gonna have a lot of company soon.
And that's a bad sign. So, in a while you guys will be able to see some choppers flying over the horizon there. I will show you guys. This playthrough of me is just looking around. This is not a good playthrough. You guys can see the shop is right there. And yeah, those are the light attack helicopters, and behind them are the heavy attack helicopter troop carriers. And those things are mean. All four of them. Because the light attack helicopters, they will easily find you. They have no difficulty finding you whatsoever. They hear one shot from you. You're not wearing a ghillie suit, and boom.
This is Charlie 1. We've got choppers inbound. Looks like Hinds and Helixes. Two each.
And the
this is King 6. Take out
Charlie
the troop transports before they land and reinforce the base.
And the heavy attack helicopters, on the other hand, they are carrying extra troops to reinforce the base. And not
Bravo,
only that, there's
King 6.
Also this...
Alpha team is down.
Charlie team will also be down soon, don't worry about that. So will Bravo in this run-through, actually. Not only that, there's also a Hercules plane. I think I call it a Hercules, I'm not certain entirely though. But yeah, it's one of those big planes that carries either tanks or Humvees or...
This is Charlie 1. We have breached the north perimeter.
Bravo! King 6! Charlie team is down!
Good. Charlie team actually breached the north perimeter without our help. That was nice. But yeah, so the Hercules comes along and it more or less just drops some more paratroopers into the fray, making things even more difficult for us. I tried getting them this time, but my aim sucked today, so I could not get them. Yesterday, maybe it was because of all the practice that I had trying to complete this specific stage that I could take them out reliably. Not today though. That is one of the light attack helicopters. No, that is the heavy helicopter that we should probably be a little careful of. No, that's a light helicopter, yeah. I'm just backing away from it, waiting for it to move away so that it does not notice me. Thus far, it is unaware of my presence, and I'm just waiting for it to show its side profile. And I think it is at this point that it notices me. So the thing about this helicopter is that if you fire at it, it will not be able to figure out where you are. That is the Hercules plane, but ironically, its engines are off, which is something that has always bothered me. It's like it comes around with the engines turned off, and it just drops some troops. Nonetheless, I'm just eliminating all the folks here. Should have gone to the first. But yeah, it's gonna start pooping out some reinforcements soon. Meanwhile, the other helicopters inside the base, they just chill around for a bit until you get close or you get too close. That's 4, that's 5, 6. Yeah, it drops like 6 extra troops as reinforcement. And yeah, these guys are very well equipped, and these guys are very well specialized as well. So I'm just seeing how far I can go, playing this like an action shooter at this point. Because, well, I guess I sort of wanted to drop out of that experience yesterday, playing this game. And yeah, that helicopter is now taking flight. I've taken out one of the light attack helicopters, but the other one is still active. I'm trying to take out one who might be in there. Now, at this point, taking out this base is practically useless. It has no point. You don't need to take out anybody in this base. It's a moot point at this point. Except for just clearing out hostiles. There's really no need to take out anybody in this base. I'm just destroying the communications equipment. The government is going to have to pay for that. So I see some enemies lined around on the minimap, and I try to lob a bunch of grenades in there to get rid of them, but of course it does not work. I just can't find the proper angle to get them. Most of my grenades end up flying over and landing somewhere inside the valley. So the next strategy at this point is to try it again, apparently, and then try and take out the helicopter. Now the heavy helicopters, they aren't that much of a threat after they've pooped out their little beams, and they can be taken out with two grenade launchers. two grenades, that is. But the rest of them are going to be a trouble. So you better be there. I'm just shooting there in case there are some enemies. Shoot first, ask questions later. Shoot first, shoot later. Hit that guy and missed, and he turned out to be a genius quick shot. And he hit me so hard.
All units, pull back to secondary LZ.
That my leg is faced through the wall. Just look at me. That was that for Mission Taps. Now, this mission, like I said, was one of the most difficult missions ever in Delta Force 2, or maybe even when we count Delta Force 1 as a game as well. But the thing about me is, I played this for the first time yesterday, and I played it like I think 23 or 25 times, I'm not certain on the count there. But yeah, that sort of honed in my muscle memory for this level to the point where I could finish it smoothly in the first part itself. And yeah, today I've got audio issues, so there was like a signal mix-up, so yeah, this is again a post-game the commentary. Again, the fact that this level requires stealth in a game where the enemy can detect you extremely easily is, well, sort of what makes this a difficult mission. But anyway, that was that for Mission Taps. I still don't know why it's called Taps, by the way. And the next, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Highest Bidder. Until then, take care, fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.